So we know children's animated films are not scientifically accurate documentaries, but we're back with another edition of me ruining them by asking, what if they were scientifically accurate? Let's start with the film that's perhaps given more kids mommy issues than any other, Bambi. One of the movie's main plot points is that a noble, handsome stag, the prince of the forest, takes care of the young fawn after Bambi's mother dies. Hey, Bambi came out in 1942, so I'm not giving you a spoiler warning here, okay? Anyway, in real life, male deer live most of the year in groups of other bachelors, only interacting with females during mating season. They have basically zero contact, and one would assume zero interest in their offspring. In reality, Bambi's best shot at survival would be to get adopted by another female doe. Madagascar is the next movie I'm wrecking with biology. King Julian is the leader of the ring-tailed lemurs. Lemurs are distant primate cousins of apes like us and chimpanzees, and are exclusively found on the African island of Madagascar. At least they got that right. But real lemur societies are matriarchal. Males are always lower than females in the dominance hierarchy. That means the lemurs in the movie should have been led by a Queen Julia instead. A lemur male that keeps dominant females from the best food or sleeping spots is definitely gonna have to move it, move it. Next, Zootopia. The premise of these movies revolves around a utopian animal society where all mammals are equal, where predators no longer kill and eat any prey. Sounds nice, but it's impossible thanks to biochemistry. Foxes like small-time con artist Nick, along with every one of the cat characters in the movie, are what we call obligate carnivores. This means they have to eat meat to survive. See, there's an essential nutrient called taurine that their bodies can't make, and they can only get it by eating meat. True omnivores like us, even dogs, can make our own taurine, allowing us to survive just fine without meat if we choose. But I've got my doubts about how most of the former predators in this utopian animal wonderland are getting their essential biological chemicals. Next, Dogman. The premise of this whole series is that a policeman's head comes off, and it's replaced with the head of his police dog. Hilarity ensues. Now, some Soviet scientists did do an extremely disturbing experiment in the early 1900s where they successfully used a machine to keep a dog's head and brain alive without the rest of the body. And that's all I'm gonna show you of that, because that is messed up. But does that mean Dogman's actually kinda sorta a little bit realistic? Of course not. Come on, even if a brain and head were kept alive and masterfully reconnected to every blood vessel and bone in a new body, every animal's brain is mapped to control the precise map of nerves and muscles in that animal's body. The basic coding is just not compatible. Is it too much to ask that even our most beloved movies get some of the basic foundational science right? I guess so. Follow me for more cool science stories.